Welcome to this week's Papercrafts and Piano, which, as you may have noticed, is actually a pre-recorded version because we're unavailable this evening, but we didn't want to let you down, so as usual, we've done a lovely little pre-record for you, haven't we, Craigie?
Indeed.
You all right?
Yep.
So we recorded this last week, and you can still chat along and everything, but we may not be available to chat back to you, but we'll try our best. But anyway, welcome to tonight, and take it away. I've always wanted to say that. Take it away. Is that what you say?
Take away, maestro.
Oh, take it away, maestro.
Thank you.
So tonight, I'm going to be using the Memories and More cards from the mini catalogue, the ones that match the Santa Express bundle. Sweet, whatever you want to call it. And we actually used these on my bingo night a couple of weeks ago, which was very successful. 15 lovely ladies took part, and I have got another bingo on the 26th of October, so that's just a little advert for that. And we made some lovely, really simple cards using the Memories and More cards, and these are often items that are overlooked in the catalogue. So I felt it important to share them with you. So what you can buy is a set of 20 pre-printed and scored lovely cards. You can use a spotty as the front, or you can use a plain one. Some lovely cards in that design, and then these in this design. So they're just a bit bigger than 6x4, the 6¼x4¼. You actually get lovely matching envelopes with them. They are really nice. And you get 20 cards altogether and 20 envelopes. And I think, off the top of my head, the £10.75, I think, for 20 cards and envelopes. So that's really good. So I'm going to be using those. Also, pop those down there. I'm trying to keep tidy tonight. We're going to be using the Memories and More cards, which are these little, they're really designed for memory keeping, but we call them Memories and More, so you can use them for more things. So some of the cards on here are from the Memories and More, and I will share those with you. Now, I've got a pack opened here, so just bear with me while I get a few of them out to show you. Okay, we've got there, Julie. Right, so in the pack, you get quite a few of the 6x4 cards. I think you get three of each design because I divided these sets by three. So I'll just go through the designs with you. That's a lovely one that can be a card just all on its own. Lovely bit of pure imagination there. That's another design. So you do get three of each of these in the pack. This one, I actually cut those out. So there are duplicates. That's a lovely one with the trees. Some of them are very memory keeping orientated. Yeah, that's right. Let It Snow. That's a good one. We'll pop that there. And they are a bit more memory keeping, but you've got the candy canes there. This is a really good one because you can just make a card without having to do anything with that one. So they are the larger cards. Okay, so you get these, as I say, you get three of each of these included in the set. And I am doing a class with this. I'm doing an in-person one to make 20 cards and an online one to make 20 cards. And just bear with me on the date. And then with these, you actually get six of each design. These are the smaller ones. They're so handy. So I just wanted to show you them first before we get making. They are really sturdy cards that they're made of. They're not paper. I mean, that's fabulous. So as I say, you get six of each of these in the pack. Probably got more than one pack left here. Anyway, there we go. So they're all the small cards. You also get some stickers, which are really good for your scrapbooking or doing a little advent thing with the numbers. You get some patterned acetates to overlay your photos and things. And then you also get these like wooden sentiments, wooden embellishments that are fabulous. Now I couldn't really split those for my bingo, so the ladies didn't get those. So you will get all these included in the class, full packs. But also I'm going to include a quarter of a pack of the Santa's Express papers. So I will, well, should we make a card? Should we get warmed up with this card here? And I've not finished this one actually, but I want to show you these papers in more detail. So yeah, a lovely bit of memory from Cats there. This is one of the papers. It's 12 by 12, and it's designed for you to make slimline cards, so you can cut them down and then you can end up with this lovely slimline piece of paper. So we'll replicate this card here to get started. Okay, so if you are interested in doing this class, then have a look out on my social media. I'll be advertising it very, very soon. Anybody know this song? There we go. So we've got a little winter scene there. I've just glued that on there. And then what I've done here, I've cut these out from papers. So we've got this paper here, the ho 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 is brilliant. So I've cut the carriage from that one. And then I've cut the Santa from this one. So a little bit of fussy cutting to do. Put these trees and things on here. So I'm just going to cut this out. Nice bit of cutting out. Thank you. Someone commented last week on the bingo that the little wheels look a bit like polo mints. So I'm going to pop that there. And that's going to go there. I don't actually have the Santa stamp set that goes with it, so I've actually brought this stamp set down, the Jingle Jingle Jingle, and I think I am going to cut it out. I don't know if any of you knew that song, but it's a gorgeous song from Miss Saigon, one of my favourites, and it's called Last Night of the World. Seen that show about 5 times, I think, now. It's a firm fave, I think you'd say. Bit of a musical theatre vibe tonight. Uh-huh. So I'm going to stamp the jingle there, and then I'm going to go over with the grey. Someone asked me about this on Instagram the other day. They asked if I'd done an outline with a pen, and I'd obviously done it with the stamp. I'll show you which card it was, actually. It's this card I shared on Instagram, and I'm going to try and replicate it similarly. And I did an ombre, so it faded out, and they asked me if I'd gone round it with a pen. I'm actually going to cut all these out individually. Keeps me out of mischief, this cutting out. Too bad. I know this is a favourite of Sally's. That was from Evita. You must love me. Shout out to my friends, actually, who were in Evita in October. You in town, Hall, Craig? Hello? Yeah. My friend Fiona, who played Audrey, is playing Evita. She's done it before as well. So, yeah, that's at Yeadon Town Hall. Little plug. Feel like Elaine Page. I think it's on from the 15th of October to the 19th, I believe. That's obviously in the United Kingdom, in Leeds. That one's a bit tricky, cutting that out. Okay, so the end's quite easy. Couldn't do it without our wonderful scissors. I know I talk about them on every live. We've got jingle, and now we need all the way. Now what I have got, and I'm hoping it's going to fit. You can experiment with this where you want it to go. Bring that down a bit actually. Lovely bit of I nearly said Evita again then. Lovely bit of Jesus Christ Superstar. I know we've got a few fans of that song. I don't know how to love him. Thank you. So, just finished that card, just as the song was ending. Bring him home, Santa on a train. Bring Santa home. It's Jean Valjean. Jean Valjean driving the Santa train. Just have a little drink.
You're Santa, are you?
Santa looks like he's already had one. He's smiling very well. He's smiling very nicely on this picture. Drink break. Okay. One card done. And we're halfway through nearly. We've done 25 minutes. So that's just a little upgrade to a sort of simple card that I've done. Obviously, I hadn't put a sentiment on this one. So yeah, that's one of the cards we can do. This one I want to show you. We might not do this one in the 20 card class because it might take too long, but this is a really easy one. And we're going to take our card base and we're going to grab one of those Let It Snow. And look how ace they fit. With a little border. So I'm going to glue that down. There we go. And then these little chaps are from this card and I'm going to cut them down. I'm going to cut them out. Could use that for something else, but maybe not. But yeah. Now this would be a good one to add a few sparkles to if you had little gems at home. Quite careful cutting this out. Phantom, so that's going to glue. They're going to glue on there. They look like they're having a nice little ice skate there. And then this tree, if I remember rightly, let me find it, is cut from this piece of paper here. So it's really handy because there's lots of things cut out. So actually I might do more than the tree because there's lots of things. Now this one has got a bit missing here, but that's fine. I'm just going to trim round it. have there, just like that. In fact, I might trim that. Lovely bit of Tell Me on a Sunday. Oh, I'm loving the show tunes. It's going to go down there like that. Don't know why I'm whispering. That's going to go there. And then I'm going to add this as a little extra. Oh, I do love this one. A bit of colour up there, I think. There we go. So another card. Very, very easy one there. Doing easy tonight because we're on a pre-record. This would be one that we'd do in the 20 card class. We could get those made very quickly. Okay, so what I am going to do is show you how I've done this. Alright, so I'm going to use my Stamparatus. Okay, I'm going to pop that in there. And I'm going to use the jelly. Card. I did bring some down, and I need my thinner. I'm actually gonna let me just think here. Right, it's 4 1/4. See how this fits on one of the cards. See if I've done it right. Perfect. Perfect. Yep. Okay. I'm going to pop the magnet there to hold that in place. Right. This is how to do the ombre look. Where's my red ink pad? There it is. So what I'm going to do first is stamp 'Tis the Season. Okay, I'm going to pop that there and then I'm going to pick it up with the Stamparatus. That was a lovely, I love that song. It was Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors. Made me reminisce about our show in December. Gosh, this time last year, just getting ready to rehearse for that. Started rehearsals. Oh, it was at the end of September, I think, but there we go. So look, there I got that. Tis the season to be. And then I'm going to do Jolly. I pop it down like that, face down, and then pick it up with the plate. Don't use the grey, we're going to use the red. I'm going to give this a good ink. Yeah. I'm going to maybe not press too hard. Like that. I didn't press too hard. I'm going to take this out, move it down one, and press again. Take it out, move it down, and press again. So can you see how you get the ombre look? So that means it gets lighter, it fades, yeah? So we've got Tis the Season to be Jolly, Jolly, Jolly. Yep, three jollies. Now I wonder how this might work. See if this would work. So now what I'm going to do is pop that back, lay this over the top. Sorry, I might have to put my head in the camera. And pick that up and ink that up with the grey. Beautiful. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take that and move it down, but I am going to re-ink it. And hopefully, it should be in the right place. Look at that. Magic, isn't it? It's absolute magic, that. So if you don't already own one of these, after doing this, watching this tonight, I think you might need one. There we go. And that's how that works. Yep. These just, oops, I've got the stamp left on. They just live on the back there like that. I've got Tis the Season, Tubby Jolly Jolly Jolly. Yep. And I think what I will do, I could put a train along the bottom. That was lovely. Come, have you ever played that before? Because that was lovely. You don't play it very often, though. No. It's really nice. Come what may from Moulin Rouge. So I could put Santa because he's sort of jolly, isn't he? Yeah. So let's cut out one of the Santas from the small cards. I was going to do the train across the bottom. So what we'll do is we'll see what it looks like. Yeah. If we don't like it, we can always use it for something else. I'm sure of it. I love this song. Thank you. that looks a bit plain. So I think I might do the train. Let's have a look. Ooh, had an idea. Who's to say that you have to have a whole carriage? That's a really big favourite of mine, and I know someone else who loves that song. Hopefully he's watching tonight. I know Stephen loves that song.
Yeah?
Oh yeah, he loves that. And we used to do these concerts, and a guy called Dave Willits.
Dave Willits from Phantom.
He did play Phantom, and he sings that. I've actually been in his company in a concert when he sang that. And yeah, brilliant. Yeah, it's from Jekyll and Hyde. But also, when I used to do ballroom dancing, some weeks I did the music, and I used to always put that on for a waltz. It's a lovely waltz. Yeah, there's a waltz version. You can get a waltz version of it. It's really nice. But look, you don't have to have the whole carriage, yeah? So. Some little sparkles on there, maybe in red. I thought what I'd show you, if I can get it to work, is how to do a little mini bow round a fork. This is not a very big fork, so it's hard to do it. So, have your loose end here like this. You've got it like that, yeah? So you wrap it over, but you go down through the front there. Pull it out, back. Yeah? And then it comes over the back and then through the middle. Yeah? So you've got that. And then you tie it in a little knot. Not a lot. With a really cute mini bow. Like that. I was wondering if I could add it on. Anyway, I just thought I'd show you that. I can add it to something. That was gorgeous, Craig. Dear Philomena. Is it Dear Philomena?
Dear Theodosa.
Dear Theodosa. Where have I got Philomena from? Yes, it's Hamilton, and I knew it within the first couple of notes, but yeah, it's not Philomena, it's Theodore. Anyway, it's from that wonderful musical, Hudson. Getting all my names mixed up. So yeah, that's the how to do the ombre. Probably needs a few little sparkles on there. Right, not long to go now, so I'm just going to finish off. We're doing one more card. Actually, yeah, I might do that. Okay, so what I want to show you, these cards are quite busy. So if you fold them over like that and you decide to use one of the big pre-done cards, they're quite busy, so let me just show you what I mean. I've lost all my cards now. I saw them a moment ago. I have them in my hand. So what I mean is, if you put that on there, for me, that's a little bit too busy. You might like that, you might be, but for me, this edge is a little bit too busy. So what you could do that, and then it's not quite as fussy. It's up to you. I did do it busy on the other one. All right, you could do that. You could use that. But we could also use some of the papers. So let me show you the papers that are gorgeous. Well, they're all lovely, of course, the Stampin' Up papers. Let me find. This is the one that I really love with the trees, and we could have a holly jolly. We could have our Santa like that. We could see how that looks, yeah. So you only need to cut these at 4 by 6. Oh, that was lovely. With one look. Did anyone guess the song? Did anyone know the musical? I'm sure lots of you will have. That was Sunset Boulevard. So these I just love those papers, they're really nice. So we could put have a holly jolly on there, like that. And what we could do is, we could have our Santa down the bottom, like that. Yeah, otherwise we're going to cover the letters up. Yeah. But what you can do, just let me show you this. Let me find it. This one, Merry Christmas one, yeah, has a little red border. What we could do to sort of bring out a bit more red is offset that like that. Have that up there like that. And then have the Santa like that. I think I might do that actually. Yeah. So I'm going to make this my last card. I always want to sing that bit in. So that's going to go there like that. So just eyeball that you've got these gaps similar. To cut down that. What I'm going to do is pop Santa on there with a few foam pads. Absolutely easy card there. So I hope that you've enjoyed seeing these memories and more cards in more detail. As I say, I'm going to be doing a class both in person and online very soon. So do look out for details of that, because you do get a lot included in the class and you will be able to make up to 20 cards. So let's go through the ones that we've made. I've used all the green cards tonight. So let's go through them one by one. So this was the first one that I've done, and I added the jingle all the way stamps. Yeah. Nice card there to go to someone. Then we did this one, Let It Snow, and I added this, cut these out and these. This was the one to show you how I've done the ombre technique. I am going to add some sparkles on here because I've got a couple of dirty marks. And finally, the really, really easy holly jolly one with the Santa cut out using a couple of the cards. So I will, these are another couple of designs that I did. So that's actually all from me with the crafting. Nearly made it to 55 minutes, but I've made 4 cards. hope I've given you some ideas with this set of products, and inspired you to have a go with these. I've just got a low battery warning on my phone, so let me just get rid of that. Just bear with me. That should be fine. So yeah, hope these have given you some ideas. And you'd like to join in on the class. Well, I think we're done, Craig, because I've done four cards.
We're good.
Yeah, lovely bit of musical theatre tonight.
Yeah,
I thought
we had a bit of a change tonight.
Yeah, I thought that. A lot of Lloyd Webber.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of Lloyd Webber tonight. And hopefully the our viewers have had fun. We didn't say you'd got to guess the names of the songs and stuff, but we know when we're away, you always like to try and guess the music. You have a little thing going on. So when we're not here to do it live with you. So thank you for tuning in. We will be back as normal next Thursday. And I can't for the life of me remember what week number that will be. So we'll just have to say that it could be 1156. But anyway, we will be back. In the words of Hamilton, we'll be back. And we will see you then. So thank you for tuning in, and we will see you then. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.